is actually walking somewhat haltingly. He went to the supermarket and pushed a cart last week. This in the words of Ralph Wilson before the game. So the news continues to get better and better and better after this happened 10 weeks ago, and we all feared for his life that night.
You're right, and that's the thing that Dick Geron said is, you know, it's such a good story because of the way that it's ending now, and what's going on now makes it a great story.
Steven Gostkowski will kick off for the New England Patriots. So Buffalo will get the ball. Terrence McGee, good return man. 5 return touchdowns, a Buffalo Bills record, as John said moments ago. Special teams will play a very big part if the Bills can win the game. He takes it at the 6-yard line. McGee runs laterally along the 15, and New England with good coverage tackles him at the 18-yard line. Let's take a look at the Buffalo starters.
J.P. Lossman, Tulane University.
Anthony Thomas, Michigan.
Lee Evans, University of Wisconsin.
Josh Reed, LSU.
Rob Rowe, LSU.
Michael Gaines, Central Florida.
Jason Peters, University of Arkansas.
Derek Dockery, Texas.
Melvin Fowler Jr., Half Hollow Hills High School West.
Brad Butler, University of Virginia.
Langston Walker, California.
The Bills put a premium on revamping their offensive line. They did that in the offseason. But again, minus Lynch tonight. Thomas will be the primary running back. He will begin from the shotgun. And Lossman, in his fourth year, goes deep to the left side and completes it up at the 35-yard line to his favorite target, Lee Evans. Each of them drafted in the first round by Buffalo in 2004. 16 yards.
Well, you know, when you're talking to the Patriots last night, they say the one thing they have to take away is Lee Evans. So what do the Buffalo Bills do? They come out and they throw a perfect pass to Lee Evans. You know, when they're worried about you deep, you know, you can push like you're going on and out, and that's what Lee Evans did, and then cut it off, and you can usually get a 3 or 4 yard push in that way.
Evans averaging 16 and a half yards a catch. That was good for 16 yards. And now Lossman under pressure, and he's going to get sacked at the 24-yard line. Adalys Thomas, the big free agent pickup from Baltimore in the offseason, gets the sack of Lossman.
You know, it's interesting. We always think of the New England Patriot defense as a three-man line, but they're in a four-man line. They're using a 4-3, and you see Adalys Thomas is coming from the outside, and then he just comes right in on J.P. Lossman. You know, that's kind of a confusing tactic. In fact, when we were talking to the Bills the other day, they thought that the Patriots would use a three-man line. Lo and behold, they're using a four-man line, and they did the same thing against the Colts.
9-yard sack, 2nd and 19. They set up the screen. This is Anthony Thomas, the former Chicago Bear, to the 31, tackled by Rodney Harrison. Let's take a look at the Patriot D.
Ty Warren, Texas A&M.
Vince Wilfork, Hurricanes.
Richard Seymour, University of Georgia.
Mike Vrabel, The Ohio State University.
Adalys Thomas, Southern Mississippi.
Teddy Bruschi, Arizona.
Roosevelt Culver, Broad River High School.
Sante Samuel, Boyd Anderson High School.
Rodney Harrison, Markham, Illinois.
James Sanders, Fresno State University.
Ellis Hobbs III, DeSoto High School.
And that is their base 3-4. On 3rd and 13, the pass is intercepted at the 48-yard line by Randall Gay. And Gay is forced out of bounds at the 26. So it starts so promisingly, and there's a flag down for a late hit at the end of the play. So they begin with a 16-yard completion, but then a 9-yard sack. A screen picks up a couple, and now the pick by Gay.
You know, and the Buffalo Bills knew that. I mean, the best thing that the Patriots do on defense is their third down defense. That's when they give you 6 defensive backs, all the exotics, and they gave it.
Unnecessary roughness, number 68. Half the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
Referee is Bill Carollo. The call is against Langston Walker for the late hit, and Brady's going to start deep in Buffalo territory.
And you'll see Randall Gay right here, and he's just shadowing. I mean, that's just man-to-man. Now, he knows that he has help over the top, so he can play underneath. In fact, he just reads a quarterback after a while, and he just jumps this ball. That wasn't even his man. But that's what they do so well. I mean, they give you that 6 defensive backs, They all play well. They all catch well.
Gay with his third interception of the season. So Brady starts on the 13-yard line of the Bills. Throws, caught at the 8. And that's Javon Gaffney taking the ball to the 6-yard line. He would be their number 4 wide receiver. In their first meeting this season, there was Brady against the Bills on the 23rd of September in Foxborough. 311 yards, 4 touchdowns. Those look like his numbers in just about every game this season.
But just look at him, how cool and calm and collected, and you know, the pace that he plays this game is amazing.
And now Maroney walks into the end zone. So Lawrence Maroney scores amazingly his first touchdown of the season. I say amazingly because this team has now scored a total of 47 touchdowns. Maroney is their primary running back, albeit he's missed 3 games because of a groin injury, but it's the first time he has been into the end zone.
Yeah, this is what they do so well down here, is they just run that delay play. They pull the guard. The guard leads up through, and Maroney takes it in. As you said, they didn't really say, you know, we have to watch out for Maroney down here in the goal line, because that was his first touchdown.
Extra point by Gostkowski is good. So 2 minutes and 43 seconds into the game, the Patriots, off their bye week, pick right up where they left off.
Play the Buffalo Bills in the old AFL. We used to make an Eastern swing, and after we would play the Bills, we would go and stay in Niagara Falls right across the street.
About a half-hour drive from downtown. The kickoff now fielded by Terrence McGee at the 9-yard line, and McGee will be taken down. Good form tackle up at the 31 by Larry Izzo, who's been a special teams maven for years, starting his career with the Miami Dolphins. So now Lossman, who threw that interception, comes back. Lossman got hurt in the first meeting between these teams this season when he was hit by the nose tackle Vince Wilfork, hurt his knee, came out, didn't play the rest of that game. Trent Edwards, a rookie from Stanford, came in, played pretty well, and then Lossman got his job back a couple of weeks ago. There is Wilfork.
And he better have a short memory, because that's one thing you can't, you know, throw an interception and then come back and let it bother you. You have to forget it, you gave to your Lossman, and you're on to the next one.
Here is Thomas, known as the A-Train, who will need his A-game tonight, picking up 2. Let's go back to that hit by Wilfork, which some people thought was late, but Lossman said, hey, it's part of the game. But it did knock him out for a couple of weeks.
Well, and it was late. And he was penalized for it. He was fined for it. And, you know, he tried to, you know, have it looked at. What do they call that when they do that? Appeal. He appealed it and lost the appeal.
Well, Thomas can't even get out of the backfield. That's James Sanders coming up from his safety spot. And that's a loss for Thomas on the play with 11 and a half to go in the period. A loss of 3. It'll be third down and 11.
I mean, you're going to see Sanders. He's the safety. And watch him time this. He just starts running, and by the time he gets to the line of scrimmage, the ball is snapped, and then he hits the play in the backfield. You know, he plays back there and shows a cover 2 shell like he's going to be a deep safety, and then times it where he's right at the line of scrimmage from the ball snap.
Both of his primary receivers to the left. Lossman is able to escape the sack, but can only get back to the line of scrimmage. That was Mike Wright, the backup to Ty Warren at one of the end spots, who came flying through. He was able to avoid him, but Lossman can only get back to the 30-yard line, and Buffalo will punt on a 3-and-out.
Now, the one thing that they wanted to do was stay out of third and long, and, you know, and that's gotten them the last 2 series. They got in third and long, you know, and they have the interception. Now they get in, you know, third and long. They get those exotic Patriot defenses, and they can't handle it.
Ryan Mormon, back-to-back Pro Bowls, where this is a high floating and short kick that is fair caught at the 37-yard line by Kevin Falk. A boot that time of only 35 yards. The Brady Bunch comes back 7-0. It was 34 at kickoff. It's 36 now, so global warming has come to Buffalo. 10:22 remaining in the opening period. 7-0.
4 wide receivers here. 3 on this side, 1 over on the other side.
Here come the Bills. Brady gets it away. It is caught. at the 44, Wes Welker, and we welcome in Andrea Kramer. Hi, Andrea.
Hello, Al. Well, you know, the night before each game, Tom Brady runs what he calls his reminders meeting with all the quarterbacks and wide receivers. And Brady does all the prep work for that. He'll pick out plays from the previous week's practice or the opposing defense. Wes Welker told me the goal is to sharpen things up. And another example of how incredibly detail-oriented Brady is, last night he watched about 200 pass plays against the Bills defense from the Bills' first nine games.
And right now on second and three, throws, and it's off the hands of Dante Stallworth. Perfect pass right there. Stallworth only had one guy to beat had he caught it, but he drops it. It'll be third down and three.
You know, and Stallworth knows that. And one thing about Tom Brady, if you get open, he's going to put the ball on you. He does that perfectly, and Stallworth doesn't do his part. I mean, Tom Brady reads it out. He sees he has a guy wide open, gives him the ball right there. And then, of course, when you tap yourself on the top of the head, that means it was your fault.
Third down and three. Out of the shotgun from the 44-yard line. They'll show blitz. They come. Protection is good. Pass is perfect. It is caught by Benjamin Watson, the tight end. It's taken down at the 41-yard line by Whitner and Butler.
You know, the Buffalo Bills, had their pass rush defense in, four defensive ends, and you see them standing up there, and then they bring the blitz. But look how calm Tom Brady is. I mean, there's a pass rush, there's four defensive ends. You know, they're coming on pressure on him, and he just stands back there, and the faster they come, the slower he gets. He slows everything down.
First and 10 from the 41. Maroney. He gets taken down by the middle linebacker, Giorgio. And let's take a look at the Patriots starters.
Tom Brady, Michigan.
Moss Maroney, University of Minnesota.
Randy Moss, Rand University.
Dante Stallworth, Grant High School, Sacramento, California.
Wes Welker, Texas Tech.
Benjamin Watson, University of Georgia.
Matt Light, Purdue University.
Logan Mankins, Fresno State.
Dan Gilpin, Boston College.
Russ Hochstein, Nebraska.
Nick Kazier, University of Toledo.
Hochstein starting for the injured Stephen Neal at right guard. It is second down and 12 now from the Buffalo 43-yard line. Fake inside handoff. Now Brady buys time. Look at that protection. And then that's dropped by Randy Moss. So go figure. Two perfect passes, one to Stallworth and one to Moss, get dropped, and it's third down and 12. Stop the presses.
Right. And the thing that you mentioned, Al, was so good is the pass protection and the time that Tom Brady had. And you see the pattern that Randy Moss runs here. He starts to run like a hook, and then he continues across. And he should know by now, Tom Brady is going to keep you alive. He has great pass protection. He's going to keep going, you know, and you keep going. He'll get you the ball.
Out of the gun again. Brady stepping up, feels the pressure, going for a touchdown, has it. That's Randy Moss for six more.
I guess Randy Moss learned from the play before, and he did stay alive and knows it. If you stay alive, Tom Brady's going to get you the ball. But again, the on the play before that, he had great pass protection. This one here, he had to move around a little. Here's Randy Moss here in the outside. And again, they're trying to bump him, but they get that safety with the inside route. He takes a step to the inside, and he leaves Randy Moss alone by himself. You see, George Wilson goes for the slot. And then when he goes for the slot, he's the deep guy, and there's no one outside on Randy Moss.
His 13th touchdown reception, and this their 10th game of the year. Gostkowski for the extra point. So Randy Moss in his first year with the Patriots. Tom Brady right on the money. 14-0, New England. 7 Eastern time, Philly at New England a week from tonight. 14-0, the Patriots. And we're not even halfway through the opening quarter as the kickoff is taken a yard into the end zone by Terrence McGee. So he will get flattened up at the 18-yard line. One of the old heroes for the Patriots as far as this season. And right now they have a 14-0 lead. The ball is at the 18 as Lossman throws, and that is caught, and that will be a first down as it's taken by Josh Reed, who'd be their number two receiver, tackled by Rodney Harrison. Now the Bills don't get a lot of national exposure, so some of the guys to take a look at tonight, you line their stars. Lossman, of course, is the quarterback. Lynch is out with the knee injury, but outside of Adrian Peterson, he's the best looking rookie running back in the league. And Lee Evans has been here since 04, and he is Lossman's primary target.
I think their left tackle, Jason Peters, is a very good player.
This is Anthony Thomas, the guy taking the spot of the injured Lynch for a gain of 5.
When we align the stars, we never put those offensive linemen in there, do we? But I think that Jason Peters is going to be one of those guys that is going to be an elite tackle. You know, he's been moved from right tackle to left tackle. He was a tight end at one time. He's very, very athletic. You know, he'll be tested with Richard Seymour in this group tonight, but I watched him on film and I really like the way he plays.
I think it's short shrifted because there are no statistics to put up for offensive linemen. There's a whistle here. Bill Carollo will make the call.
275, 52, 98.
Full start, 82, offense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Just throwing some numbers up there for right, the guys, whatever they mean.
Right, and if there are none, who knows any better? So we do have to get that for offensive linemen, though. Something that gives them some numbers so that we can, when we align our stars, we can throw a lineman in there every once in a while.
And that's why it's harder for an offensive lineman when you're talking about a guy on the verge of getting into the Hall of Fame or not, whether it happens. So what do you compare it to? Is it's caught here by Lee Evans, and Evans is stopped at the 39. Here are some numbers for the offensive line. One thing about this line, plenty of heft. 332 pounds is the average. They're the heaviest offensive line in the league. That's in contrast to their defense, which is smaller and faster.
Right, and and they knew that they had to improve their offensive line, so they went out and got Derek Dockery from the Washington Redskins free agent. Gave him a lot of money. Langston Walker, the right tackle, number 68, gave him a lot of dough. And then drafted number one, Marshawn Lynch, to kind of go with it, to help this running game.
And third and one, here is Thomas, and he's able to pull his way over the left side behind Peters and company for a first down up to the 41-yard line.
And that's where if you're going to run the ball, we're talking about Jason Peters and Dockery right here, and that's not a bad place to go. Isn't it something how Rodney Harrison is a safety, is wherever you run the ball, wherever he starts, he's going to end up where the run is.
And he's been doing it for 14 years.
Well, he's a good player.
And that may have been tipped, he may have been hit before he got the pass away. The pressure was put on by Adalis Thomas, who earlier in the quarter had a sack. Thomas last year had 11 sacks with the Ravens, but playing in a different defense. His sack before was his first full sack of the year. He came in with just one half this year.
Yeah, because he's playing outside again tonight. What the Patriots are doing is they're playing a four-man line. Mike Vrabel's not playing. Adalis Thomas is playing this position right here, or outside the linebacker, in a 4-3 defense.
Pressure from up the middle. The line does a good job initially, and then coming in is Jarvis Green to knock it loose. Picked up by Lossman. His throw is somehow one-handed near midfield by Michael Gaines, and Gaines takes it to the 44-yard line. That'll make a few highlight reels tonight. That's a 14-yard gain. Eventually.
Right, and that gives Bill Belichick something to get mad at. But this is what J.P. Lossman can do. He's a pretty good athlete, and he has a strong arm. Loses a ball, picks it up on the run, keeps looking downfield, keeps his focus there, and hits Michael Gaines with it. That's a Tony Romo-type play. He Romo'd it.
Ball is at the 46-yard line, and Lossman gives it to Thomas. Thomas is taken down just shy of the line of scrimmage. James Sanders, the first man in.
When you talk about this New England Patriot defense, I think sometimes you get caught up with the linebackers in their 4-3 and the blitzes and all that stuff. And really, the strength of this defense is a defensive line. And they usually just use three of them. The last two games against the Colts, and tonight, though, they're playing with four defensive linemen. But that whole defense, or the whole success of this defense, starts with that front group, this group right here.
And they got Seymour back a couple of weeks ago. Richard had not played for the first month and a half of the season with a knee injury. And now Lossman's going to launch one deep down the sideline, adjusting and making the catch is Roscoe Parrish for the touchdown. That's a 47-yard touchdown, and the crowd is frenzied.
That's one that J.P. Lossman is going to look for. He's going to look for Roscoe Parrish, especially when he gets man-on-man coverage. Number 27 is Ellis Hobbs. He has man-on-man, and Roscoe Parrish, one of his big play guys. Good speed, can score anytime he gets his hands on the ball. That time the ball was a little underthrown, and Parrish made a heck of an adjustment.
That is the first completion against the Patriots this year of a pass of more than 30 yards from the line of scrimmage.
Well, they caught him in a blitz.
Ryan Lindell for the point after. What a turn of events that was on that drive. J.P. Lossman almost lost the ball, gets it back. And Buffalo now halves the New England lead, 14-7. What a turn of events. You know, if Lossman loses the ball and the Patriots take over at about the 20 and Brady takes them into the end zone, that's a kill shot, 21-0.
Right.
Keeps it alive. All of a sudden, now you go downfield, hit Parrish instead of 21-0. It's 14-7. Short kick fielded up at the 13-yard line. And running it back is Willie Andrews, a backup safety and special teams performer who brings it back up to the 28-yard line. That's where Brady will start. Randy Moss, 7 years in Minnesota, two lost seasons in Oakland, the years between 98 and 04 with Minnesota. And then in Oakland, I say the two lost seasons. Then the people began to think, well, maybe he's lost it a little bit. Maybe he's lost his fire. And then all of a sudden, you get hooked up with Tom Brady, and you're back in the Hall of Fame.
And he's playing like that, too. I mean, there was a time, other than quarterbacks, that I thought Randy Moss was the best player in the NFL when he was at Minnesota. And then he went, like you said, and he was with the Raiders, and he didn't do much. And then I thought, maybe he lost it. Maybe it's injuries. Maybe whatever. And now I watch him this year, and again, I'm starting to think that other than quarterbacks, I mean, take them out of there, he could be the best player in the NFL.
Well, right now, the MVP of the league would have to be Brady, as Bill Carollo now has a discussion with Dick Geron. They whistled this to a halt before the first play of this drive.
You know, and Tom Brady was talking about Randy Moss last night, and he said, you know,
Buffalo is challenging and ruling on the field that it was a fumble. We'll reveal the play.
Well, let's go back then to the kickoff here. Dick Geron wants to challenge and see if it was a fumble that would have been recovered by the Buffalo Bills. We'll take a look back in a minute.
But there was nothing that Bill Carollo could do, because when he looked at the evidence, there was no picture of anyone recovering the ball.
I think that's exactly right. Somebody upstairs said challenge, it's a fumble. But when you go all the way through it, it wasn't going to be changed. Then Brady throws the ball into the ground as he was pressured. And since he was inside the pocket in what they refer to as the tackle box, if you draw a line straight back from the tackles and you're in that pocket, you can't ground the ball. There was no receiver in the area. Brady's going to argue the point. Carollo picks the flag up and they'll have a discussion.
He's probably arguing the point that it was a screen pass and they grabbed his screen guy because
intentional grounding, number 12 on the offense. Quarterback was out of the pocket, the foot to the ground, did not get the ball in the line of scrimmage. This play is a spot of the foul. Will be second down, includes the loss of down.
And the thing is, you watch him, he's gonna fake to the left here, like a screen to the left right there. He's gonna fake it right there. The red lines are the tackle box. He's outside the tackle box. He was trying to throw a screen pass to Kevin Falk, and they do allow him. I know what Tom Brady is saying is on the screen pass, they do allow you, if you don't have the screen, to throw the ball at the guy's feet. He threw it at his feet, but he threw it about 3 yards to the left.
That's Brady's first intentional grounding call in two seasons. Second and 22. Now Brady throws over the middle. It's caught by Stallworth on the run. And Stallworth to the 30-yard line, tackled by John DiGiorgio. Brady's still arguing the point here. A guy like Stallworth, who's been a primary receiver in the past with New Orleans and then he went to Philadelphia, boy, does he fit in beautifully with Moss and Welker. You've got three guys right now, and Brady has almost an all-star team to throw to.
Right, and that's it. I mean, Randy Moss is the best number one receiver because he can go deep. Dante Stallworth can catch those crosses like that, so he's a great number two. And Wes Welker could be the best slot or third wide receiver in the league.
On third and eight, Brady guns it, and that is a sliding grab made by Jabbar Gaffney. So you have the big three, and then you have the holdover Gaffney, and there's a pretty good number four receiver when a guy can go to the turf like that and pick up 30 for you on third down and eight.
Yeah, Jabbar Gaffney is the slot or the inside receiver here. He's just going right up the seam. But you see what Randy Moss does. I mean, he grabs so much attention. Everyone is going to the outside receiver. The outside receiver, they let that inside receiver go right up the seam.
Now Maroney in those three games with a groin pull. Takes it to the 37-yard line. He'll have to be the main man now. They had Sammy Morris, who they had picked up, who had done a pretty good job for them. But now Morris is on injured reserve. So Maroney, a high draft choice, number one out of University of Minnesota last year in his second year. There's his average, 4.6. Excellent.
But you know, with those receivers we were just talking about, and with Tom Brady and the pass protection of this offensive line, the running game is not a big part of what the Patriots are going to have to do this year.
Second and seven. Maroney, who scored a touchdown at the outset of the game, picks up the first down. He's tackled by number 95, Kyle Williams. That will move the chains with a minute and 15 and ticking down left in the quarter.
I've always been one of those guys that say you have to be able to run the ball, especially in the Eastern Division, and stop the run. And when you're talking about this group of Patriots, I don't know that that's true. I don't know that they're going to come out and pass the ball. And I think if you're playing defense against them, you have to go to stop the pass.
Final minute of the period. And they give it to Welker on the end around. He avoids getting tackled in the backfield and turns it into a short gain. He's tackled up at the 25-yard line by Terrence McGee.
He can do a lot of things. You know, we talk about Wes Welker as a slot. You know, he can return kicks. He can run reverses like this. But he is also a very, very good blocker. You see, this is just where you fake inside, then get Welker, to the outside and end around. And one of the best things, as I said, that he does as a slot is block for the running game. He's outstanding.
Got him in a trade with Miami in the offseason. Now Brady goes underneath, hits Randy Moss, and that's enough for a first down. It'll be first and 10 at the 17 when the second quarter starts. End of one. New England start the second quarter in Buffalo. Al Michaels, John Madden, Andrea Kramer. You know, we were talking about it. Andrea mentioned the work ethic of Brady and what he did last night. He's Peyton Manning-like in that regard. You know, Peyton sets the standard for that, but Brady's right there as well.
You know, it's amazing. Last night, after we talked to him, he was going to go to his room and watch all nine games of the Buffalo defenses. Then he was going to meet with his players.
And here on a slanty, it's Randy Moss who avoids a tackle and then works his way to the corner of the end zone for the touchdown.
Doesn't he just make it look so easy? And Randy Moss does too. And you know, they used to say Randy Moss wouldn't go inside. He wouldn't run a slant, wouldn't run an in, wouldn't run across. You know, he knows how to do that. I mean, he's just a football player that'll do anything. I mean, he catches that ball on a slant going to the inside, doesn't really want to go too far in there, and says, let me go back and try that other thing out there where there's no guys. Boy, he is a threat on every play, isn't he?
McGee says, anybody get the number of that jackrabbit? Gostowski for the extra point. So Brady doesn't let the penalty affect anything on that drive. Three possessions for New England. Three touchdowns. Most TD passes through nine games. Marino had 27 the year he had 48. Manning, of course, 31 in 04, finished with 49, the record. Brady, 33 through nine. And then two more tonight. So that's 35 for Tom, who's on a pace, as you saw, through nine games to eclipse Manning's mark and could very well be into the 60s and set, I mean, just about every record imaginable. His pass rating is up over 130, which is unheard of.
You know, like I said earlier, I've been watching football and been a part of the NFL for a long time, and I don't know that I've ever, in fact, I do know, I have never seen anyone play this position of quarterback better than Tom Brady's playing it right now.
And Randy Moss has been rejuvenated. The Patriots, I mean, let's face it, even before they got Moss and Welker and Stallworth and Adalius Thomas were a force, a team that was going to be a Super Bowl contender, whether they got those guys or not. And then, I mean, it's almost like the rich get richer. They go out and they find key guys who've done tremendous jobs, and that's why right now people are talking about the Patriots as having the possibility of being maybe the greatest team in the history of the NFL.
Yeah, and I think so. I mean, especially offensively. You know, I mean, we haven't even gotten to the offensive line yet. You know, and that's the most underrated part of this team.
Gostowski, a short kick. Now McGee, who got beaten by Moss on that last touchdown, runs this back. And it's a good run back as he brings it back up to the 44-yard line. Let's go to Andrea.
Well, you know, guys, talking about Brady's football mechanics, nobody may know his game better than his personal quarterback coach, Tom Martinez, who's worked with him practically every offseason since Brady was 13 years old. His main goal, getting Brady to understand why things happen mechanically so he can make in-game adjustments, which Brady told me he does. Well, Martinez told me the most underrated part of Brady's game, how pocket tough he is. He calls him the best he's ever seen at moving in the pocket, keeping his eyes downfield, and throwing the ball at the last possible moment.
That innate field, so much in evidence through his career. Six-round draft choice out of Michigan. Back in 2000, Rossman's going to throw it over the middle, and it's dropped by Anthony Thomas. And, you know, it's funny because we sat with Brady last night, John, and we said to him, I said, look, what motivates you now? And the first thing he said is, he says, you know, I was a sixth-round draft choice. So here it is years later, as if to say, hey, I was a sixth-round draft choice, and I will never forget it.
Right, and I think that's a reason that, you know, that he's in there. You know, we talk about his work ethic and lifts weights and studies films and practices, and you know, he has made himself the best.
Second and 10, Thomas again. Thomas is going to turn the corner, and Thomas on the run picks up his first down. Anthony Thomas, who has played very sparingly this year because the rookie Lynch has been so good at one time. Not that many years ago, when Dick Geron was in Chicago, he was the primary running back for the Bears.
Yeah, Roosevelt Colvin is out there complaining to the officials. If you watch him right here, the end man in the line of scrimmage, he is being held right there by Kirk Chambers.
5 yard penalty, replay, second down.
And you've got a flag that's going to negate that run. Illegal formation is the call. So there goes a 17-yard gain.
Well, you know, that was Kirk Chambers, who was playing tight end with an ineligible number. And I wonder if he went in there and didn't report that he was playing tight end, because
73.
Right, he's in there now, and he did report. He must have gone in there, not reported, but it was his block that really sprung Anthony Thomas. His block and his hold. It kind of did hold Roosevelt Colvin.
Rule is, you have to inform the official and he has to announce it. Second and 15. And Rossman avoids the first wave, but not the second. Roosevelt Colvin was there. He should get the assist because Adalius Thomas is going to get credit for his second sack of the night.
You know, I think that Colvin was mad at Chambers for holding him on that play before. And you're going to see he comes here and beats Chambers to the inside. He starts outside. Chambers thinks that he's going to stay outside. Once he steps out, then Colvin just goes to the inside.
And Thomas, who had, as we said before, just one half of one sack all season, has two in the game. On the move again, Lossman's going to keep it. Lossman around the left side, up past the 40. And Lossman out of bounds at the 46-yard line. Mike Vrabel is there, and that's going to be fourth down.
Yeah, the Patriots have gone to a 3-4 now. The Vrabel wasn't in there before. Adalis Thomas was playing the outside. Now they're back in the 3-4. Vrabel's back in there. They had a blitz from their left side.
Throws down the middle, touchdown!
Field goal hit the top of the crossbar, hit the extension on the backside. It's a good field goal.
Back to throw down the middle of the field. Guess who? Owens, wide open, touchdown, Cowboy!
Pretty crazy day, especially that game in Baltimore, the way that one ended. At the 16-yard line, Brady now on first down, the fake, and then open over the middle is Benjamin watching out past the 40-yard line for a first down with 12 and a half to play in the first half.
You know, it's just amazing the surgery that this offense does to you. I mean, they go four wide receivers, then they go three wide receivers. Now they come with two tight ends, and you think, oh, this is going to be a running formation, and then, boom, he hits Ben Watson down the field. And they go back to three wide receivers, shotgun.
25-yard gain. Maroney. You know, John, I was thinking before, the last time we saw the Patriot, we'll stop thinking about it to the extent that it permeates every conversation. And that's really what's happened. People haven't stopped talking about it, but it's like it's almost been forgotten, and the Patriots have rolled over everybody to the extent that all people are talking about now is a perfect season. On second and six, that is caught by Wes Welker to the 40-yard line of Buffalo.
Well, I think the other thing you said is they have played great. I mean, then they went from, you know, the Spygate, that whole thing, to, you know, will they be undefeated? But the thing that made it possible was the way they're playing. I mean, they're playing at such a high level. I don't know offensively, you know, I talked about Tom Brady. I don't know that I've ever seen anyone play the game as well as he is right now. Offensively, I don't know if I've ever seen an offense as good as this offense is right now.
I mean, there's only been a little bit of drama all season for the Patriots, and that would be in the Indianapolis game where they had to come from behind. Here's Maroney. But what they've done after the incident in the Meadowlands is, in effect, if anybody thought they got some sort of advantage out of that, whatever it would be, it would have to be so minimal in the context of what this team has done, how it's playing. Belichick, of course, has won 3 Super Bowls, did it over a 4-year span, and there's Bob Kraft and his son Jonathan and his wife Myra, who's put together this organization, which right now, in many ways, Spygate notwithstanding, has become the model franchise for professional sports in terms of how you run it, how you succeed, to be financially sound, and all of the rest. Second down and 10. Screen, caught, fork to the 31-yard line.
Yeah, the Patriots are showing us now the different things that they can do from the shotgun that doesn't involve throwing the ball down the field. And we saw on the play before where they get in the shotgun and they run it to Maroney. And then they get in the shotgun and they throw a screen pass. And then this here is just a play where they run a screen pass, not from the shotgun. But you know, you think downfield, you think receivers, and they give you a tight end. You think receivers are tight end, and then they go to running backs, and that's what they're doing on these last couple of plays.
Third and 2. Dante Stallworth, and he'll take it to the 21-yard line, where DiGiorgio makes the tackle. So the Patriots trying to get into the end zone for a fourth consecutive time.
You know, this will put you in a little bind, Al. If your defense, they take their 3 receivers that we're talking about. You know, their 3 best receivers, Randy Moss, Dante Stallworth, Wes Welker, and they put them all on the same side. The good news is one of them is going to get the ball. The bad news for them is 2 of them has to block.
on the 21. They're going to give it to the up back. They let Keith Evans carry the ball. He gets about one or two carries a game. It'll be second down and nine. We're talking about their receivers, and last year, I mean, Brady's never really had a stellar bunch. He had Richay Caldwell, he had Troy Brown, who may or may not come back this year. He's on PUP. Doug Gabriel, and there they were through nine, and now this year, you have Moss, who has caught five fewer passes than Welker, and of course, Stallworth with a lot of big grabs, and Gaffney, who's played a big part tonight as well.
Now you just think of the pressure they put on Brady last year with that group of receivers. They knew that that wasn't enough, so look what they went out and obtained.
And then you hit Falk, and Falk's the guy who comes out of the backfield. Maroney is the runner, and Falk is the third down guy. Lost the ball for the moment, but falls on it. And Falk a little slow in getting up, may have fallen on the football.
Yeah, Randy Moss was right down there with him and raised his hand to get someone in there from the sideline.
He gets to the 11-yard line. That will be a first down. And hopefully just a case of having the wind knocked out of him, which is what happens oft times if you fall on the football. Bill Belichick's going to come out and take a look, and Falk is now able to get up. So an injury timeout halfway through the second quarter. One of the all-time good guys, the longtime coach of the Bills, took him to four Super Bowls, Marv Levy, still active. The GM of the team under Ralph Wilson, watching his club right now trying to stave off the Patriots, who lead by two touchdowns. Have a first and 10. Falk went off the field under his own power. Brady is able to feel that pressure and just step up and step out and slides to the hole at the 6-yard line without even turning his head, John. He can just feel it coming around the left side and turns what would have been a sack into a game.
Here we're talking to Josh McDaniels last night, the offensive coordinator. He said they work on that all the time, that he has great presence. I mean, he feels pressure, and he knows how to get away from it. And that was the exact thing there. I mean, he felt the pressure. And his eyes, he's looking downfield. He's focused downfield, but he knows it's there. I mean, you get to one point where I better get the heck out of there. And he looks back, and he sees a dark blue jersey, and he knows it. And he gets as much as he can. Goes into a slide.
Even absorb the slightly glancing blow on the helmet.
I think that's probably what told him to run.
Second and six, going to the end zone, caught, touchdown. Moss just stops in front of the defensive back, and Brady is right there on target, and that's four drives and four touchdowns.
I think, you know, Tom Brady, this New England offense, and Randy Moss is just too much. I mean, here's Randy Moss on the outside. He doesn't even run a pattern. I mean, he just runs up there and stops, and Tom Brady throws it to him. You know, Jabari Greer is right there, and he said that when he was in high school, they had a term that if you got beat, you were mossed. He was just mossed.
Gostkowski for the extra point. Outside of Indianapolis, New England is now turning the rest of the league into the Washington Generals. They are the Harlem Globetrotters. Today's show in Buffalo tonight. It's 28-7. The kick is fielded at the 7-yard line and then dropped. Gathered at the 12. The coverage is terrific. Terrence McGee has nowhere to go. Willie Andrews gets down there, and the Buffalo Bills will start deep in their own territory. 6:27 left in the half. The Patriots looking like the Patriots. Because when the American Football League was formed in 1960 with eight teams, Ralph Wilson was one of the eight owners of the called the Foolish Club. The Buffalo Bills are still the Buffalo Bills, and the pass is incomplete. Of course, John, you're an AFL historian. Bud Adams, who had the Houston Oilers, now the Tennessee Titans, are still around. We lost Lamar Hunt last year, who had the Dallas Texans and the Kansas City Chiefs. But you think about Ralph Wilson, small market and all of the rest, and he's hung in there through the years. 47 years later, here he is.
Well, he really held the league together, and you know, I started off in the American Football League, and anytime I see Ralph Wilson or, you know, Lamar Hunt or any of those people that, you know, started the league, I always thank them, you know, because if it hadn't been for them starting the league and you didn't have the opportunity, you don't know what would have happened.
Second and 10 is Washington. Flag is down. secondary obviously doing a tremendous job as Lossman couldn't find anybody open. Randy Moss checking out what the call will be.
He looks like he's checking out to see if he can get a hot dog someplace. This is way too easy for him.
Three touchdowns tonight for Moss, who's caught four passes.
And that last one, that last touchdown, he didn't even run a pattern. Ran the end zone, turned
around. Illegal use of the hands, hands to the face, 96, defense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Adelius Thomas. That play looks like that's a parking lot play. I'll run over here, and you throw me the ball in front of the Chevy.
You know, and I think the way Randy Moss is playing and the way he's smiling tonight, you know, is so happy. I think you could do that. I think you really could tell him, you just run out there and then just stop and I'll throw it to you, and it would be a complete pass.
First and 10, the ball is at the 18-yard line. And it's a 7-yard pickup for Anthony Thomas. Well, there's a lot to be happy about for the Patriots and their fans, and of course a lot of stories about what's going on in Boston right now with the Red Sox winning the World Series. Doc Rivers off to a great start with the Celtics, who finally lost their first game of the season tonight. The Patriots, of course, the Revolution soccer team, also owned by Bob Kraft, got to the finals today of the MLS Cup, but lost to Houston 2-1. Second and three from the 25-yard line. And even the Bruins have a winning record, albeit they're in fourth place in their division. Anthony Thomas up to about the 28.
Yeah, they're back to their three-man line again. You could just see, you know, those three defensive linemen, Vince Wilfork, Ty Warren, Richard Seymour now, just controlling the line of scrimmage. I mean, there's no place to run. Vrabel's not in there. Davis Thomas is now playing an outside linebacker. And they're all role players. In fact, Bill Belichick said the other day, he said, the only guy on this team that only has one position is Tom Brady. He said, everyone else, if you're going to be on this team, you have to be able to do multiple things.
They're going to be a little short of the first down. And so it'll be third down and that much. Brady, when we talk about perfection, tonight he's 14 of 17. That's not perfect, but think about this. The three incompletions were a drop by Moss on a ball right on the number. That's a perfect rating, by the way. A drop by Stallworth and a grounding call that he disputed. Those are your three incomplete passes. Third and inches. And Lossman tries to sneak his way for a first down. Close.
And you know, that's tough when you have Vince Wilfork in there over the center. That's tough to get a quarterback sneak. Here's Wilfork right here, and you got to get something on him. He gets a penetration. There's no place for Lossman to go. I'm surprised that he got that first down. I mean, Wilfork did exactly what he had to do, and Lossman was going in that same hole.
Got it behind his center, foul with three count, gives away at least 15 pounds. Now Lossman dancing around. And down he goes at the 20-yard line. Adelius Thomas is part of that tandem along with Ty Warren. That should be another half sack for Thomas. So he comes in with a half a sack for the season and has 2.5 tonight.
You know, and a big thing is he's playing a different position, as we said earlier. You know, they had moved him to an inside linebacker, and where he'd gotten all the sacks in the past was, you know, coming from an outside linebacker type position, and that's a position he's playing tonight, and that's when he's getting the sacks.
Second down and 17. Will Thomas come again? Nope, drops back into coverage this time. And Lossman brings it to Thomas over the middle, and it's Anthony Thomas, stopped by Bruschi and Colvin up at the 33. And Bruschi is down.
8 of 11. You know, aren't those inside guys something? I mean, Teddy Bruschi playing as long and as well as he has, very good tackler, Junior Seau in there with him.
Vrabel's going to come back in as Brewski needs a moment. He may have been hit by Seau, his own man, on this play. There's Junior coming in 55.
I don't know. I saw him, you know, both make the tackle on this play, and I think, isn't that something? I mean, they're two inside guys there. If you throw it, they're going to make that tackle. Junior did come in a little late on that, didn't he?
So the three converge, and Brewski a little slow in getting up. Teddy now in his 12th year. Very much one of the faces of this franchise, especially coming back from the stroke, of all things, about 3 years ago. And they thought his career was over. And, you know, we're just worried about his health and all of the rest. And here he is playing at still a very high level. Been a Patriot since 1996.
You know, I think it's guys like Teddy Brewski and Junior Seau that just kind of epitomize, you know, this Patriot team. I mean, you can tell them anything and they're not going to get satisfied with anything. And I think that's why Bill Belichick can treat the team the way he does. They have so much confidence that he can kind of beat them down a little, but he really can't beat them down because they don't believe it. Now, if they were a bad team, they'd have to believe it when he would beat them down.
Third down, six. And Lossman throws, and the pass is a little low, and it is caught, they say, by Lee Evans up at the 49. That's going to be close. I mean, the Bills are now going to rush up to the line of scrimmage because they don't want the Patriots to have a chance to challenge. So they'll try to get the playoff. It's a 16-yard gain. And they cannot get the playoff before the call from upstairs. And that's what an offense will do. The ball clearly bouncing, even though it was ruled a complete pass. Belichick will throw the flag. Carolla will take a look under the hood. Yeah. And this one figures to be reversed.
And as you said, J.P. Lossman knew it. You know, 'cause he probably saw the whole thing.
New England is challenging and ruling on the field that it was a catch. We'll review the play.
And so he tried to get up there and get that ball snapped, you know, and get a playoff so it couldn't be reviewed. Bill Belichick or his staff said, you know, that ball hit the ground. Let's throw the red flag. Belichick puts that red flag in a funny place. When you see him throw it, you ever see that? It comes out of his sock somewhere. I mean, he has to go down and start pulling his pants up and his socks down and all that stuff to get that red flag. And that's why it takes a little longer than most.
You think it'd be a little bit more accessible.
Here it is right here. Look. Right. See, the pants have to come up.
Yep.
And then you have to get the red flip. He's just that's what he's putting it away. But to get it out, he has to go through that whole rigmarole.
Well, Belichick, of course, is now known as a coach who wears nothing but a hoodie and a cutoff sweatshirt on a warmer night. And so the irony is when they travel, they get dressed up. So when they got off the plane yesterday and we have our meetings with the Patriots, here comes Belichick in a suit and tie, and you barely recognize him.
Right, and then during the game, I think he wears what you call give-ups. You know, you get to a point where you don't care what you look like. You just want to be comfortable.
Yep.
And you wear give-ups. I mean, that outfit that he's wearing, well, that outfit that he wears every game is a give-up outfit.
Pretty much sums up Bill in many ways. He doesn't give a damn about a lot of stuff. I mean, his press conferences, he won't give anything up in those. If it was up to him, he would never deal with the media or anybody else. He's there to coach football. Everything else is a distraction. And it's reached the point where he's had so much success that, you know, a lot of the media would like to really bash him, but you can't. The team is so good. He learned at the knee, of course, of Bill Parcells. But with Parcells, even though Parcells never gave up anything, Bill reached the point where he loved to parry with the press, and his stuff was comical.
After reviewing the play, to determine the ball hit the ground, therefore it's an incomplete pass. It'll be fourth down and six at the 32-yard line. Correction. At the 36-yard line. It'll be 3:02 on the game clock. 3:02 on the game clock.
So they win that challenge, and that means that Belichick still has one more challenge at least, and were he to challenge and win that one as well, he would have a third. Wes Welker now drops back, and Brian Moorman to do the punting.
Do you think he's going to need a third? Do you think he's going to need any help in this game?
No. I think he can put that thing under about five pairs of socks right now.
That looks close to being there right now. Corolla's trying to get his boot straightened out here.
Punt of the game. Called in by Welker at the 24, and he hops up to the 28-yard line. Patriots with a lot of records ahead, and even tonight, take a look at this. Brady now with a franchise record. Babe Parilli, the old record holder. Steve Grogan was the old record holder, and he has 36 TDs in his first 10 games. That's an NFL record. Moss, a franchise record and most in a player's first 10 games with a new team. And we are, you know, we're just 9.5 games into the season. It's going to be crazy by the time this is all said and done. A lot of marks will be obliterated if this keeps up.
It's going to be interesting. The Patriots are going to be going into their two-minute drill, and Tom Brady, you know, talking about how competitive he is. Bill Belichick had, you know, a drill where it was the first offense against the first defense, and he said he went three and out. So let's do it again. Let's do it again. So again, they went three and out.
Convert on second and one. That's Moss underneath. He gets up to the 41-yard line, and that'll be a first down.
And Brady was talking about how he was upset about that for 2 days. And this is the thing that they were practicing. This is the thing where their defense took their offense on and beat them.
And that is dropped by Walker Jermetrius Butler with the coverage on it. So we're at the 2 minute warning, second and 10 when we come back. New England, 4 drives, 4 touchdowns, up by 21 in Buffalo.
You know what I had the other day?
What's
because
that?
I want the hot one. Yeah, you know, you're mild or hot. The heck of that. I had suicidal.
But
that's hot. And but I love it. I mean, I ate them all.
Like how many?
All of them.
Second and 10. This is caught by Welker up at the 50-yard line. One of those all-you-can-eat places?
No, they just brought a load of them in, and they just, you know, put them on the table, and I just started eating them out of the box. And pretty soon they were all gone. No more suicides.
Third down and 3. And Brady fires, and that's caught over the middle, and Randy Moss makes the catch. He takes it to the 40-yard line. Patriots have all of their timeouts. They have a minute and 25 seconds and ticking down. The ball's at the 39-yard line.
You know, and Tom Brady was saying, you know, how he really believes that you play like you practice, and practice is very important to him, and he's showing it right now.
And one of the few off-target passes as Crowell came in and hit Tom Brady, and we'll check in now with Andrew again.
All right, well, guys, Kevin Falk is questionable in his return with a head injury. Now, remember, they're already thin at running back with Sammy Morris out, so they lose a lot of versatility without Falk. There's no one in particular that would take his reps on third down. You'll see more Lawrence Maroney, and if they need to spell him, they'll go with Heath Evans.
Well, there's Falk. We had thought he had the wind knocked out of him, but it's a different story. Heath Evans, number 44, flanking Brady out of the shotgun. Tom hanging in, almost hit from behind, gets it away. Welker makes the catch, picks up the first down, and falls down at the 28-yard line to move the chains. We are now under a minute, and again, the Pats have all of their timeouts.
It looked like he just signaled out here to Randy Moss over the top. I wouldn't be surprised. Randy Moss is down here at the bottom on the right. I wouldn't be surprised if he took a shot at him or shot to him right now.
Instead, he comes underneath again, and that is caught by Welker, who goes out of bounds at the 24-yard line.
You know, we always talk about the offensive line and being the most underrated part of this Patriot offense. And watch Matt Light, their left tackle. I mean, That, you know, he's blocking their toughest guy, you know, all night. Usually the left tackle has the toughest guy, and Matt Light does an excellent job. This whole offensive line does an excellent job.
Loss again, close to a first down. Ball is at the 18-yard line, tackled by McGee. And timeout is taken by New England, and they may also take a look at a measurement here as well with 28 seconds remaining in the half. Randy Moss tonight, 3 touchdowns, 7 catches, 96 yards. Tom Brady has already thrown for 271 yards, and that'll tell you he's on a pace for about 550. Parrish was able to keep Buffalo in the game early when the score was 14-0 with a touchdown. They'll measure here. New England has 2 timeouts and 28 seconds on the clock. Come up a little bit short, which is hardly of any consequence at this point because it's all about the time remaining.
You know, I know at some point you get on, you know, are they piling it up? Are they doing this or that? And as Bill Belichick's dad told him years ago, and I totally agree with it, it's not the offense's responsibility to stop themselves. It's the defense's responsibility to stop them. And if you don't want them to score, then play defense right now. I mean, go and stop them. You know, pass rush, get a sack, you know, get an interception, knock a ball down, cover a guy, do something. But you can't say, you know, they piled it up on us. I mean, make a pass rush, make a play. Make a defensive play. It's their responsibility, not the offense's responsibility to shut it down.
Amen. Third down and inches at the 18-yard line.
The crowd wants his Buffalo defense to do something.
And they're going to give it to Evans, and Evans is going to pick up a first down, 17-yard line. That'll stop the clock with 22 seconds.
And that's what Andrea was talking about, Evans taking the place of Kevin Faulk. That would have been Kevin Faulk's play. You know, where they get in the shotgun down here, and they probably run the ball from the shotgun as much as anyone. And that's a kind of a new thing for them, you know, that they figured if we're going to use the shotgun a lot, you know, we better have some runs from it. And they do very well with it. That now he's going to that second level of wristband plays. The top level would be for the regular part of the game, and then when you flip it over, it's the 2-minute part. So he's in the flip part of his wristband.
A look at Faulk. Andrew talking about whether he returns. First and 10 from the 17-yard line. Patriots with 1 timeout remaining. Brady going for 6 more, and that's incomplete. Intended for Randy Moss. Going through the middle of the end zone, and Brady upset with himself for not connecting with Randy.
You know, he had 5 touchdowns once, and he said, you know, instead of thinking, you know, that was great that I have 5 touchdowns, he thought I should have had 7. And this is what, I mean, he has one here. I mean, Randy Moss runs great patterns, has great speed, and you look at the time that Tom Brady has, and he's usually very, very accurate. He got that one a little out in front of Randy Moss.
Second down, 16 seconds. Brady again to the end zone, and that one is caught, and it could be a force out, and it is. By Moss for the touchdown. Randy Moss. And you can feel it. I mean, after they missed connections on the one over the middle, you knew he's going back to number 81 again. 4 touchdown catches for Moss tonight.
Right, and that's that 2-minute drill. And I had that same feeling that Randy Moss is wide open and he doesn't hit him. He's going to come right back to him. On the one that he missed him, he runs an in. This one, he runs a corner. He just comes like he's coming to the inside, fakes to the post, and goes back to the corner.
Didn't even matter if it was a force out. He got both feet in anyway. Possession, control, tucks it in. Gostowski for the extra point. And the New England Patriots, who come into the game averaging over 39 points a game. And I mean, think about it in these terms. In the NFL, the average number of points in a game combined is about 42 and a half, otherwise known as the over-under. This team is almost over by itself in every game.
You know, and they make it look so easy. You know, you think, you know, pro football is hard, playing quarterback is hard, getting open is hard. But when you watch them do it, it doesn't look difficult at all, does it?
Randy Moss. Well, how about a day in which Moss and Terrell Owens each with four touchdowns?
There could be a connection there, too. You know, I know Terrell Owens watches when he sees Randy Moss do something. And I'll bet you that Randy Moss knew what Terrell Owens did today, too.
Halfway through 10 games, 9.5. There's the most through 10 total games. So he's already established that record. He has 30 more minutes of football, or maybe a little bit less tonight if Belichick decides to sit him down.
And you know what he'll say after the game? He'll say, I have a lot of work to do. I mean, we have to get right back. We have to watch the film. We have to get ready for the Eagles. You know, I have a lot of things that I have to work on. And, you know, part of him, I think, is believing that now.
Yeah. Well, if you're a perfectionist, that's how a perfectionist thinks. And I think in almost any line of work. Oh, yeah, that's pretty good. Well, what about next week?
Greatness is never satisfied.
This is Fred Jackson taking it up to the 43-yard line. So Moss hauls in the fourth, slides into the cameraman.
Has a discussion with him. Gives right. Him a high five. Slams the ball in front.
Gave his camera back, says, how's your F-stop?
I'll tell you, that's when you're playing the game with a lot of confidence and awfully relaxed.
And having a lot of fun. Yeah, they're having a lot of fun.
Yeah, they're having a lot of fun at the Buffalo Bills' expense. You know, and these fans come here and they want to cheer and they want to yell, and it's a great venue and it's a great place, but you know, when you're down 35-7 at half, what's a crowd to do?
You know, you talk about a coach coaching every situation. You figure Lossman's going to, just in case he decides to throw a Hail Mary, you put Moss back on defense. And, John, you talked about all these guys except Brady playing a lot of positions. So here's Moss playing goalie now.
Yeah, the more things you can do.
Well, Owens played on defense today as well.
Moss is back there. He was back there just a minute ago talking to the crowd.
Three-man rush. Lossman with a great arm. He's going to launch one in the direction of Moss, and that is knocked down. So landing in amongst about a half dozen Patriots. And that is the way the first half will end. Like the best team in the NFL. No argument. We have a halftime show coming up next. 35-7 at the break. Free thought for Philadelphia and anybody else on the rest of their schedule. 35-7.
I wonder what they're thinking right now. You know, like, you know, watching this offense and what we have to go in and start putting a game plan together for it. Where do you start?
That's Chad Jackson running it back to the 27-yard line. That is the question. Let's go to Andrea.
Well, Bill Belichick, still a man of few words, but he did have to say, no revelation here, that they did a good job throwing the ball, they got a good rush from their outside linebackers, and that they should expect a big passing game from the Bills in the second half as they try to get back into it.
All right. There are the New England possessions tonight. Five times they've had the football, five times they've gotten into the end zone. And Brady is thanked for 287 yards. Lossman, meanwhile, 7 over 13. 114 as Brady starts with an inside handle out of the shotgun, and they give the ball to Evans, who takes it up to the 33-yard line for a gain of 6.
And because they can run like that, they can get in the shotgun on any down and distance. And you see that was a first and 10 play. They get in a shotgun. Make the defense think, you know, it's a passing play, and you have to, you know, rush a passer, get a passing, and then just run a draw in there on them. And they do that very well. That's usually the play that Falk runs, but Again, Falk is injured, so before we have Heath Evans in there.
So close of a moment ago, Aaron Schober, who's been the best defensive player here, is Evans again. What the Patriots do is they take everybody kind of out of the mix here. A guy like Schober, we haven't even mentioned his name tonight, because New England has just been shredding that Buffalo defense, aligning some of the stars. Of course, Brady on a pace to throw for over 550 yards. Not that he will, because they have such a big lead. And I know people think that they pour it on, but they won't do it to that extent. Maroney averaging just 3.2, doesn't matter. And Moss, 8 receptions, 4 touchdowns.
And I would add Matt Light to that. We're talking about Aaron Schober. Well, Aaron Schober's a Pro Bowl player. And as you said, you haven't mentioned his name yet. Well, then you have to mention the guy that's blocking him. That guy's Matt Light.
Dante Stallworth makes the catch. Randy Moss, among other things, as you look at Schober again, 4 touchdown receptions in the half. And that would tie an NFL mark.
And one thing the Buffalo Bills are doing, we see Schober when he's coming out. That's a rotation type of thing. You know, where you always try and keep those defensive linemen fresh so you get a good pass rush, but it hasn't worked for the Bills tonight.
Second down and 5 from the 47-yard line. And Evans. And again, Evans is seeing a lot more action now because Falk is hurt. Sammy Morris is on injured reserve. And you have Maroney, of course, but now Evans toting it.
I would have to guess that there's also something wrong with Maroney.
There he is on the sideline.
Because if, you know, if you had one back and it's not, you know, a third down thing, and they usually get Maroney, you know, out on third down, you put in Kevin Falk, but Maroney is usually the first and second down guy. And now they're playing first and second down with Heath Evans.
Fake to Evans. Brady guns one right on the money. Stallworth makes the catch. He gets taken down at the 25-yard line.
And the thing that they do is you know, just have such a feel for these zones. You know, that if there's a zone and, you know, they get in and they sit down and hook and work back to the quarterback, and Tom Brady just reads. He said, there's nothing a defense can do anymore to me that I haven't seen. So I recognize everything, and I know perfectly what we're doing.
Now they have Kyle Echol as a running back. And Echol takes it to the 18-yard line. First-year player out of Navy. Echol, number 38.
You know, there's a lot of amazing things about Tom Brady, Albert. Just the way he makes it look so easy. I mean, you know, and again, like I said, I know it's not easy. It's a very difficult thing being an NFL quarterback. But just watching Tom Brady do it, you wouldn't believe that, would you?
So many of the greats do make it look so easy in every sport. 2nd and 3. And Dante Stallworth not able to pull that one. And I keep thinking about, like in baseball, Johnny Bench always made catching look so easy.
Yeah, and you know that that's not, yeah. And you know, I think the epitome of that was Joe Montana. I mean, he was that guy that, you know, did the same things that all the other quarterbacks did, but made it look so easy. And Tom Brady, I've always said, is a lot like that. But I also feel that right now Tom Brady's playing this position in the NFL better than anyone has ever played.
3rd down and 3 against the blitz. He steps back, throws. It's caught at the 13-yard line. Gaffney's taken that. Classic case there. The pressure's on. He could feel it. He takes a step back, finds his man. His number 4 receiver moves the chains.
And what they do is he sees the blitz coming, so he knows that he's going to have an open lane to the inside. And Gaffney just goes right in there where the linebacker's left. You know, they tried everything. The Bills have it. They tried to rush him. They used 4 defensive ends. We just saw him blitz on that play. There's nothing defensively that they can do that can stop Tom Brady.
10.5 to go in the 3rd. Echo to the 9-yard line. He goes for a gain of 3.
From the handoff. And on Colnell makes the tackle.
You know, it's a tough thing if you're a defensive coach and when you're coaching this Bill team, you know what you tell them. I mean, you have to play fast. I know they say that. You know, we have to get pressure on Tom Brady. And you know what you have to do, but they're so good, they just don't let you do it.
Second and seven. Brady gets jostled, but gets it away to Evans. And he's a yard short of a first down. So it'll be third down and one inside the 5-yard line.
You know, but these guys that they put in are always ready. I mean, who would think that we'd be seeing Heath Evans and Kyle Echol, you know, as the two running backs for the Patriots?
Perry Fuel with a lot of company around the league right now. What do you do? I mean, you put your hand to your head.
He looks like he has one of those excitement headaches.
Yes, he does. Third down and one from the three. Short shotgun formation here. Brady only a couple of yards back of center.
Actually, he has the back behind him, so he's still handed to him.
And then he throws into a lot of traffic, and he can't jam it into Moss. Broken up by Jabari Greer. So it's fourth and one, and one of the few decisions that Belichick has to make tonight. But it's a nice decision to have to make when you're up by 28.
Yeah, Jabari Greer does a nice job there of getting inside and getting that right arm over the top. You see, and that's what he did. He just chopped Randy Moss's arm down. The Patriots are going for it. Fourth down here, and the fans are booing it. They're all standing up to boo.
Well, they're booing because they're saying, you're pouring it on. Why don't you just go for the field goal?
I would hope that they're standing up to cheer on their defense to make a play.
A fourth and one. That's going to the corner of the end zone and hauled in for a touchdown by the tight end, Ben Watson.
Yeah, I mean, you have to get a rush. I mean, that's the thing. You say we have to take away the receivers, but it starts, you have to get a pass rush. You have to get to Tom Brady. You can't let him stand back there, pat the ball, and look all over the field, and finally throw it to Ben Watson. But, I mean, you know, at some point, you have to put pressure on
him. Got by the strong safety, Dante Whitman, Gostkowski, with the cushiest job in sports. Just kicks extra points. Well, the cushiest job in sports is to be the Patriot punter. He won't even need a shower tonight. 42-7 New England. Speaking of chucking, Tom Brady's been chucking it 35 times tonight for 27 completions, 325 yards, and 5 touchdowns.
Now, you know, he said before he had 5 and got upset with himself, thought he should have 7. And that's probably what he's thinking right now. I ought to have 7 tonight.
Gostkowski at the 19-yard line. Terrence McGee. And McGee gets out almost to midfield with 8:41 remaining in the third. Patriots up by 35 in Buffalo. Buffalo has the ball at its own 48-yard line. Teddy Bruschi is back in the game for the Patriots as Buffalo begins this drive from the 48-yard line. Lossman will swing it to the outside. It's caught by Fred Jackson. Played at Poe College, which is the alma mater of Marv Levy. Jackson, first-year player. Played in NFL Europe and in the one of the indoor leagues, not the arena league, and there is the venerable one, Mr. Levy.
It's hard to be venerable now.
Yeah.
Or maybe after watching this, you get more venerable.
Well, you get vulnerable when you play New England.
Very much. I mean, he just has to hope that, you know, offensive, just get something going. Just do something positive.
2-yard gain for Anthony Thomas. Think about this. Buffalo comes into this game with a 4-game winning streak. So they're hot. But they were, you know, they may be red hot, as we said at the top. The other team was white hot.
You know, it just shows where the league is right now. I mean, there's Buffalo, a hot team that, you know, wins 4 in a row. And but they haven't played anyone like the Patriots. I mean, I think you have the whole league, and then on top of the whole league, you have a team like the Patriots. And then you have, you know, another group, and then Buffalo's probably in that third group.
Third and one as Lossman comes out to the left side. He may run for the first down. He will. Puts it in his left hand and steps out of bounds and at least gets the first down. Well, one thing that we have discovered this year, John, is that parity does not exist in Foxborough, Massachusetts.
No, and that's what makes it so impressive. You know, with free agency, you know, we all felt there will never be a dynasty again. And, you know, that I'm not exactly sure what the definition of a dynasty would be, but I think what the Patriots have done is as close to a dynasty as you can get.
They've already been, in a way, dynastic, no matter what happens this year. As this is Thomas to the 35-yard line, they've already won three Super Bowls in the decade. They may have the best of all of their teams right now. They're still young enough in so many positions as you look at the AFC best march at the moment. Colts win today. They're still minus Marvin Harrison, but they were able to squeeze one out against Kansas City. Steelers get upset by the Jets. Jaguars beat San Diego. Titans play tomorrow. Second and seven.
And I think if you had to say, you know, who's the next best team, you know, to the Patriots, you may have to go to the NFC.
I think you do at this point. And that's incomplete. You wouldn't have said that a couple of weeks ago, obviously, with Indianapolis, but the Colts have just been racked by the injuries to Harrison, Clark last week. Of course, they've lost Freeney for the season. Cowboys came from behind to beat Washington. They gave him a run today. Of course, Green Bay, a remarkable story. Favre playing exceptionally well. Knock off Carolina. Giants went over Detroit today. And then you have Tampa Bay, Seattle, and the Lions at 6-4.
Yeah, I think right now, after the Patriots, I would jump to those two teams, the Cowboys and the Green Bay Packers, as playing the best football right now.
Third down and seven. Incomplete, intended for Josh Reed. It'll be fourth down.
Now the fans are booing this. I think they feel, I kind of feel the same way, that, you know, it's fourth down, you're down 42-7, you got to go for it. And you know, and they're, you know, kicking field goal here, so I'm not sure. You know, I mean, you just think, you know, you had to get something, and maybe Dick Geron is just looking for something positive, like I felt you had to get, and maybe he thinks a field goal would be a positive thing.
A field goal from 52 yards out. Ryan Lindell on a windless night. And Lindell right down the middle, but it hits. It hits
it's
the
good.
Camera. I think it hit the camera. So in Baltimore today, you had one go over the crossbar, a disputed play. We'll check it out when we come back. Take a look at this. It hits the camera, and that's beyond the crossbar. It's good. The camera is not good, but the kick is good. Brady's numbers. Oh, he's not perfect. 158.3 is perfection. A few drops along the way. Close enough. 25-yard line, first down. Five touchdown passes, sixth possession for the Pats. Six touchdown drives. Brady's going to go over the middle on first down on play action. And that's Moss for a gain of 12 and a first down. Some of the things Tom has done and is doing. Only quarterback since 1950, two winning streaks of 12 or more games. 95 or better is rating each of the first nine games, and tonight that'll make it 10. And if he holds on to a 32-point lead, he'll be 78-1. I might bet on it. Well, as of 1-1,000. First and 10. Brady. He's caught by Stallworth. You know, we talked about the fact that some people think that the Patriots pour it on. They won games by big margins. And, you know, John, we discussed this before. Some people think, well, it's the perceived slight of Cameragate, Videogate, or Belichick has it in for certain other coaches and all that, whatever. I mean, these are it's conjecture on the part of people that very often don't know what in the world they're talking about. The one thing about Belichick with Dick Jerome, he thinks the world of Dick Jerome. Second and five. And this would not be a case of trying to embarrass another coach.
No, but this is just pro football, and you just keep playing. I mean, there's going to be some point here where he's going to take Tom Brady out, though, I'm sure. And I know, you know, as a coach, I never considered those types of things until the fourth quarter. I would never consider anything like that at this point. If you say, what is Tom Brady doing in there? There's a football game, and he's still playing football. And here it's just a handoff, and, you know, he lost all his running backs, and now all he has left is two fullbacks, and they're running through gaping holes.
Yeah, you're running a guy that nobody's ever heard of on the most basic of plays. I mean, what else would you like him to do? And the guy gains 14 yards.
it gets back to whose responsibility is this, and it's the responsibility of the defense to not let him do this. But I think this defense is so beaten down, they haven't had any answers, and they're not sure where they're going.
Well, Brady will give him a breather, if nothing else. Timeout, New England. Randy Moss with four touchdown catches, nine catches in all tonight, and 125 receiving yards. Andrea.
Yeah, well, you know, sometimes coaches get enamored with opponents who have big games against them in the past, yet when they sign them, they're never the right fit on their team. Well, not the case with Wes Welker. Patriots Vice President of Player Personnel Scott Pioli told me they played against Welker in Miami for 3 years and could never stop him as a receiver or a return man.
Speaking of Welker,
and although, you know, Pioli rarely gets wrapped up in statistics, Welker's production, like we just saw, really struck them. Remember, he has the most combined yards in the NFL since 2004.
Andrew, you just won the timing award.
Right,
thank
and
you.
The thing that is, you know, I mentioned this before, that is most impressive when you watch him on film is how good a blocker he is. You know, if you play, they play three wide receivers, and if you put a nickel back in there, you know, instead of a linebacker, if you put a nickel guy in there, he will dominate that guy in run blocking.
24-yard gain for Welker, who has now caught seven passes tonight, 78 yards. And Brady on first down, stepping away, stepping out, slides to a stop at the 15-yard line with 3 minutes to go in the third.
Yeah, and he's laughing there because that's the last thing that he wants to do. I mean, you know, his job is not to run with the ball. His job is to get back there and get it out of his hands and get it to his playmakers, and that's what he tries to do. But, I mean, he has so much time. I mean, that's not even a pass rush. I mean, he looked to his right and pumped, and then he looked back in the middle, couldn't find anything. The only thing he saw was a great big hole on his left side.
7-16. It is college football. Nene, free agent, signed to the active roster on October the 1st. Scored a touchdown in the Dallas game.
I always like to see that, you know, to see an NFL player from a service academy. I mean, there's just something, you know, good about that. I mean, that goes back to Roger Staubach and Navy. And you see, he had to play with Navy and he's in the NFL now. And I think pretty good.
Bill Belichick's father was a coach at Navy. Third and three. Here's Eckler again. He's going to take it to the 10-yard line. So now you have a fourth down. And so do you kick a field goal? Do you go for it? You know, not that it's going to matter in terms of the game itself. He's looking over to Gostkowski.
I don't see any field goal team coming in, so I know what they're doing.
You know, what's pouring it on more, kicking the field goal at 42-10 or going for it on fourth down?
I don't know. I mean, I don't think either of them. I mean, the defense just can't stop them, and, you know, this is going to happen.
Moss on a slant. And that will be a first down. First and goal. Sunday night.
Thursday. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone.
Oh, yeah. First and goal. The ball is at the 7-yard line. And taking it to the one is Kyle Echo, and that's going to take us to the end of the third quarter. Three almost totally perfect quarters for the New England Patriots, and thus far a perfect season. And we will go to the fourth quarter with the score New England 42, Buffalo 10. New England, and right now New England on the verge of going in for another touchdown, which would be their seventh on seven drives on the 37-degree.
Look who's in there, Al. Junior Seau's in there as a fullback. Mike Vrabel, number 50, is a tight end.
And they give it to Echo, and Echo will try to work his way in for a touchdown, and he does. Reaches the goal line, the signal goes up, and Kyle Echo scores the touchdown, his second of the season.
Now, if you're a linebacker, you should know how to block a linebacker and watch Junior Seau. He's at the fullback position. He runs out, gets that linebacker, leads on him, and Echo just runs right inside. Vrabel was down there blocking at the bottom of that pile also.
Vrabel's no stranger to lining up with the football in the end zone. Gostowski for the extra point. 404 points for New England this season, the most for any team in the first 10 games in the history of the National Football League. The Bills logo. The Bills take it at the 6-yard line. And a kick to be run back here by Terrence McGee up to the 25-yard line.
Terrence McGee on the return.
14 seconds into the fourth period. Big night for Brady, as usual, 49-10. And then so after the Philadelphia game next Sunday night, you're taking a look at all of the games remaining on the Patriots schedule. Baltimore and Foxborough. Pittsburgh. Actually, the Baltimore game is in Baltimore. Then Pittsburgh at New England. They play the Jets, Miami, and then their final game against the Giants. At Giants Stadium, is the new running back here is Dwayne Wright. You know, John, as we look up, you know, the teams that have been undefeated late in a season, it doesn't always take a really good team to beat an undefeated team. Back in 1990, our buddy John Robinson's Rams were 3-7 and knocked off the then 10-0 San Francisco 49ers.
Right, and you know, and that can happen. I mean, this is the NFL, and you look at teams and you say that, well, the Patriots look so good that they should win every game, but there's so many things that can happen between now and then.
Dwayne Wright loses the ball, and it is plucked out of the air, and this is Ellis Hobbs going in for the touchdown.
Mike Vrabel, he said, when it rains, it pours. That's the thing, when you're just trying to get something going, and you know, and the Patriots have had everything going their way tonight, and you know, and that was a good hit. I mean, you can't say, geez, that was a bad break for Buffalo. I mean, the Patriots make things happen. They make things happen, obviously, on offense, but they make things happen on defense. The Patriots made that happen.
And then, of all things, James Sanders knocks it loose. The momentum is going out of bounds, but it comes out at the back of his hand, which keeps it in bounds instead of out of bounds. It's like a ball hitting the tree and winding up back on the fairway. Seven more, 56-10.
I wonder who thought they needed that much at any time. That's an old building, but at some point, some guy has to say, hey, we need a big old city hall here in Buffalo.
Some contractor made a lot of extra money building that city hall a lot of years ago.
I don't think we're going to see any more Tom Brady tonight.
Ball taken at the 6-yard line by Terrence McGee. Patriots have already equaled Penny. So Tom Brady is finished for the night. We'll probably see Matt Castle coming in. Anthony Thomas is the running back here with Lossman at quarterback. Ball at the 19. False start.
Yeah, I think one thing, the way the Patriots have played, they've had very few penalties tonight.
False start, 66, offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
All right, here's something you will only hear on, we cover the world on Sunday Night Football. Bill Carollo is the ref. He reffed the game last week in Miami, with Buffalo and Miami. He is the first referee in 35 years to ref a game for the same team in back-to-back weeks. Now, I knew you were dying to hear that, as that pass was almost picked off. And the only reason was Bill Levy was ill last week, so he would have been the referee. And Carollo had a week off. It was his bye week. He had to go to Miami to replace Levy, and he was already assigned to this game.
Right, so it's Carollo doing the two games in a row, but not his crew.
Right.
I mean, last week he had Bill Levy's crew. Tonight he has his own crew.
And if you're just tuning in and you're wondering what we're talking about, just take a look at the score. Second down and five. The ball is at the 16-yard line. Lossman throws over the middle, and it is caught in one hand. And it is Josh Reed as he brings it in and is taken down up at the 35-yard line.
Yeah, Josh Reed is kind of the second receiver on this team. He looks like a lot like a running back, but he's a very smart receiver. And you know, they haven't done a lot tonight or gone to anyone a lot, but J.P. Lossman has a lot of confidence in him. I think that Evans is his big play guy, and Josh Reed is kind of the guy that he depends on for those kinds of routes.
And a 10-yard gain for Anthony Thomas. Marshawn Lynch hurt. Take a look at. We don't see him, but the league has seen enough of him already to know he's pretty good.
Yeah, you know, he's from Oakland, so I've known Marshawn Lynch or about him, you know, since he's been in high school. Then he went to the University of California. And he was a local East Bay guy, and there's something special about him. And I talked to him the other day. He thought on Friday he was going to be able to play, but he looked at him and he had his ankle in a boot. I mean, he couldn't even walk, and he said, well, I'm going to take it off tomorrow. I'm going to practice on Saturday, and I'll be out there Sunday night. I'm telling everyone, hey, Marshawn Lynch said he's going to play. Now, there's no way he was going to play, but he's going to play well in this league for a long time.
Carry the ball the second most times through week 10. He's fifth in rushing. Of course, Adrian Peterson, who's also hurt, is the rookie who's gotten all of the attention. That's why you probably haven't heard that much about Lynch. From the 47-yard line on first down. Lossman going deep into a lot of traffic, and it's broken up inside the 5-yard line. That's Ellis Hobbs, who ran the pick back for a touchdown, telling the crowd not even close to being good.
You know, I think you can see in these Patriots that when you watch them practice, this is the way that they practice. I mean, there's no, oh, we're way ahead, you know, it doesn't mean anything. Everything is full speed. I mean, the ball's in the air, boom, there's three defenders right on it. I mean, they just have so much pride and so much confidence and so much talent. They only know one way, and that's to play everything 100%.
Second and 10 from the 47-yard line. In the air and it's caught, but a negligible gain by Anthony Thomas. It's almost like you're afraid to let down your coach. I mean, this is the way Belichick coaches. He coaches 60 minutes, he coaches every week, and it's like you're afraid because you know if you do something wrong, even if it's 56-10, he's going to run the film for you.
Right, he's going to point it out, and then I think he has these players so well trained that even if he didn't point it out, they would point it out to each other. So I think part of it is the coaching, and I think another part of it is the players.
Third and 12. Lossman will have that one knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Sedalius Thomas having a big night.
Well, he's having a big night because he's playing all over. You know, this is a thing that we talked about. You just can't be, you know, a one-position guy on this defense. We see him now here, and again, that's where he's done the most damage tonight, is coming from the outside. He's been an inside linebacker most of the time. He's played a little inside linebacker tonight, but for a big part, he's been the left outside linebacker and pass rusher.
Brian Moorman is the punter. Another short kick that's fair caught by Wilker at the 23-yard line. Under 11 to play in the fourth, with the Patriots up 56-10 in Buffalo. Chris Hansen, one of the great jobs in America. He's the Patriot punter. Had to give him a shout out here because we haven't seen him tonight. In fact, he has punted so infrequently this year as Matt Cassel is the new quarterback and gives it to Evans. Hansen has punted so infrequently he doesn't even qualify among the league leaders. He's had to punt X number of times, but that's how infrequently they've had to use him.
Well, you're going to have to start counting punts into the net. That's all he does. It's a relief pitcher that just warms up in the bullpen and never goes in. He's been warming up all night. He's been punting into that net all night.
The last time the Patriots played a game without a punt was 1978. Meanwhile, here's Castle, who played at USC with his great quarterback tradition, but he was not part of that tradition as Evans gets the first down. Castle, for the most part, playing for the Trojans, backed up two guys who won Heisman trophies, Matt Leinart and Carson Palmer. But he was a seventh round pick. They knew enough about him. The Patriots said, well, maybe this guy can be a guy who we can use on the roster. Here he is.
Well, remember about three or four games ago, Bill Belichick put Matt Cassel in, went in, threw an interception. Bill Belichick took him out and put Tom Brady back
in. Back in Miami, yeah.
Then he came back in another game and threw a touchdown pass. He scored a touchdown.
Evans again. We mentioned the respect Belichick has for Dick Geron. You think back that these two guys have known each other for 30 years. When Geron was playing safety for the Detroit Lions, Belichick was there as the assistant to the special teams coach. So that's the first time these two guys met each other.
Did Bill Belichick just yawn?
Maybe he's doing a commercial.
Check that label.
He wants to get into that yawning thing that I see Wade Phillips and a couple of other guys doing. Second and four. Here's Evans again. You know, it's been a pretty good weekend for the Belichick emerging coaching tree. It's been a rough year for Charlie Weiss, obviously, in Notre Dame, but they beat Duke yesterday. Eric Mangini's had a bad year with the Jets, but they upset Pittsburgh today. And how about Romeo Crennel? And what about the Cleveland Browns, who had won that miracle game in Baltimore today, and all of a sudden the Browns are back to win a game of the lead in their division. What a job by Crennel.
Right, it was just a matter of time. You know, I mean, he started there and he took his lumps. They were down, you know, had some draft picks, you know, picked up some free agents, and you know, he's showing what he could do as a coach.
Evans, a lot of shocking things in the league this year, and the Browns would rank right up near the top. I mean, all of a sudden, Charlie Fry starts the year. He lasts a game. He goes to Seattle. They've got Brady Quinn in the wings. All of a sudden, Anderson emerges. You have this craziness today where originally they said the field goal by Phil Dawson was no good. Then after a discussion, it was good. They get the ball in overtime and beat Baltimore.
The players left the field, then they had to come back and play in overtime.
Yep. First and 10 at the 48-yard line. The real major shocks this year. Kyle Echol stopped at the 49-yard line.
This is a thing, you know, you say, you know, holding back, and you're going to look at this score 56-10 and think that, you know, the Patriots ran it up on someone. And this, again, this is pro football. I mean, you only have so many guys on your team, and you can only, you know, play so many, and you know, the opponent has to get out the way they got in.
55.
Second down.
What a decent.
Evans breaks through the line and carries the ball to the 40-yard line of Buffalo for a first down, and the Patriots tonight have now gained 501 yards.
You see, Evans is the lead back or the fullback, and usually you know, that fullback will lead and block, and you hand it to the tailback. That time he was a lead block or the fullback or the first back, and they hand it to him. Something how the backup quarterback starts to look like the starting quarterback. They have the same mannerisms.
You morph into him. Here's Kyle Echol again. Seeing a lot of action tonight.
Yeah, I think there is something to that. I think the backup does morph into the starter. I mean, look at Matt Cassel here and the things that he's doing. He looks like Tom Brady. I was watching him in the pregame warm-up, and the way that he would stand and throw, he throws and has the same mannerisms and the same motions as Tom Brady.
And he was 6'4", as is Brady, and 225, as is Brady.
What a team!
But he ain't no Brady.
He ain't no Brady.
What a team!
To the outside, Echo. Third down. Brady with 5 touchdown passes tonight. Most points per game in a single season. The Rams back in 1950. Almost 39 a game. They're on a pace to do that. Total points, the Vikings in 98 at 556. So Pats are on a pace to obliterate that by about 100 points.
And then you have the Miami Dolphin record.
That's right. And then the Patriots are going to face the Dolphins in December. Well, you're talking about the Miami Dolphin 1972
right,
record.
Yeah, right. I'm talking about that record, you know, and that's the one that everyone, you know, is asking now. I mean, it went from Spygate to, you think they can go undefeated? You think they can have a perfect season? And, you know, they're on the road to doing that. And if this guy keeps playing the way he is, like I said, I've never seen anyone ever play this position better than Tom Brady now, and that includes Joe Montana. I always said that Joe Montana was the best offensive player that I've ever seen while doing this, but Tom Brady, right now, this year, I think is playing better than Joe Montana ever did.
There could be no higher compliment.
You know, and you think of Brady to Randy Moss and Montana to Jerry Rice, you know, which combination of those two would you take?
Well, Rice and Montana, and then Rice and Young did it for so long.
There's another combination.
Yep.
But right now, the way they're playing this year, before you get to meanwhile, I would take the scoop here. I'm sorry.
Well, meanwhile, there is Chris Hansen. So we were talking about him. We put the anti-kibosh on him. We got him into the game.
He finally got out of that net. I think he was tangled up in the net one time tonight.
Few Patriot opponents are going to need a net this year.
He's going to let the clock run all the way down. Now they break the huddle.
That was like a mini grin from Coach Belichick, wasn't
he? He's not going to give you a lot of grin.
No, he's not.
You know, at some point you have to enjoy it, though. I mean, here you are, you're 10-0, and you have to let yourself be happy for just a couple of minutes.
You would think Bill never shows it.
False start, 38, offense, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
I think, though, in his own way, he relishes stuff that rest of the world he doesn't let in on.
Well, you know, you hope so, and you hope that the players are enjoying it, because it is a game, and you're going to look back on it as the, you know, best time of your life. And if those things are true, you have to enjoy it and have some fun. And I know that the most fun when you're in this game, believe me, is winning. There's nothing more fun than winning, and if you don't win, there's nothing that's any fun.
And that'll be a touchdown.
different Bill Belichick this year, and he said, nah, he's still his old, same sarcastic self. He expects a lot out of us, rides us, and respects us. So he gave me an example. He said, they'll beat a team by a lot, but when the players come in, he'll show them all the negative plays from that game. And Rodney told me after about 25 minutes, you feel lousy, like you could have beaten the team by even more. But what kind of humble pie could Belichick possibly feed them? I have no idea after this game, but Rodney Harrison told me they do need that.
Well, think of something. Fred Jackson.
Yeah, and like I said earlier, I think that, you know, this team is so good and these players, you know, have so much pride and confidence that they can take that. I mean, if they couldn't take that, you wouldn't be able to do it, and that's probably why he does it.
Secondly.
It would be hard to get on any of these guys tonight, wouldn't it? Tom Brady, doggone it, you should have hit that one thing.
Yeah.
And, Randy. Teddy Bruschi, missed a tackle. Yeah,
Randy, how'd you drop that pass?
Yeah, Randy dropped the pass. Matt Light, you missed the pass protection.
Right. For crying out loud, we had to punt once. And Hanson punted it through the end zone. Couldn't put it inside the 5-yard line. Yeah?
Right there, he's going to show him that and say, Randy, you have to catch the ball before you run. Catch the ball before you run. Yeah, okay, coach. There's a picture right there of Randy Moore smiling. I've never seen him smile so much in a game as he has tonight. And, it could be the picture for winning a great deodorant.
Catch is made here by Lee Evans. Don't forget Stallworth screwed up in the first quarter, too.
Yeah, these are the things that he can show them tomorrow. Remember that one? We think we're perfect. We think we can catch anything. Look at Stallworth pointing to his helmet saying it's on me.
2-minute warning. New England going to 10-0 with emphasis. A look ahead. And, of course, we'll put somebody up on the horse trailer.
And I wonder who that would be.
I wonder. What?
I don't know that anyone could deserve it more.
Yeah. Moss already has made his way on it. He did that when we had him in San Diego week two. But Jackson now up to the 50-yard line. Among the things that New England has done tonight, 510 yards.
You see Junior say out there, you know, here's an 18-year veteran, and you know, Bill Belichick was saying last night he plays with the energy of a rookie, and here he is at the end of a 56-10 game, and still jawing at someone, still going after someone, still making the tackle close to the line of scrimmage, still trying to fire his guys up.
He retired, and then they brought him out of retirement from San Diego and played in Miami, and he got hurt. 18th year, Belichick says he's just a dream to coach. Same words he actually used for Randy Moss, and that's caught by Evans. And John, of all the crazy stuff, when you have guys like Terrell Owens and Randy Moss, there it is. That's what they've. I mean, these two guys are like they're positioning themselves for men of the year. This is crazy.
Yeah, and you know, it just shows that you have to be in the right place at the right time with the right system and the right players and coaches, and you know, you can have the talent. But it doesn't always come out. But if you get all the right chemistry around it, it comes close to outstanding.
False start, 71, offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
That's Jason Peters. I said earlier, I think is one of the bright spots, you know, on this team. I mean, I think he's the type of guy that you can build an offensive line around. He's going to be there for a long time and plays that all-important left tackle position.
36-yard line. Asante Samuel is there for the stop. Samuel's a guy whose name we haven't mentioned very much tonight because that defense hasn't been on the field, but there's a guy who is without doubt now one of the premier corners in the NFL.
You know, when you have a premier corner, you won't mention him a lot anyway because they don't, you know, go to his side much. They don't work on him much. They don't catch many passes.
Trent Bailey. Jackson. And he will go out of bounds, and that'll stop the clock. With 21 seconds remaining in the game, New England with 56 points. Patriots with the most points they have scored in any game this season. Prior high had been 52. 24 points came in that comeback win against Indianapolis. Every other game in the 30s, 40s, or 50s.
This is what I don't understand.
Just pack it up and go home.
Right, I mean, the same guys that complain, you know, that the team piles it on and, you know, someone may get hurt and you do all this. It's the same thing when you're down 56-10 and you keep throwing and taking time out and stopping the clock, you know, someone might get